Good morning, class. How are you? This morning, I want to talk about temptation of Jesus Christ. Last time I discussed with you the baptism of Jesus Christ. Just for introduction of the lesson, I talked about the baptism of Jesus Christ last time, and I told you that Jesus Christ came from Galilee to the Jordan, where John the Baptist was baptizing people. And he went to John the Baptist to be baptized. John the Baptist refused that he was supposed to baptize him. But Jesus Christ told him to fulfill the scripture that he should baptize him. And when Jesus Christ was baptized, as he came from the water, the Spirit of the Lord descended upon him like a dove, and he had a voice from heaven, saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." And at the end of the day, that was how God manifested the glory of God upon Jesus Christ. Then, directly after the baptism of Jesus Christ, he was led by Satan into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And the Bible made it very clear that just in course of that time in the wilderness, Jesus Christ fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. And after the fasting, that was when the devil knew very well that Jesus Christ was very hungry. And he went to Jesus Christ. In the first temptation, he told Jesus Christ, "If you are the Son of God, turn this stone to become loaves of bread." And Jesus Christ answered him, "It is written that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God." Satan did not leave Jesus Christ alone. He proceeded for the second temptation. He took Jesus Christ, in the second temptation, he took Jesus Christ to the pinnacle of the temple, the highest point of the temple. And he told Jesus Christ, "If you will fall down from this pinnacle, that God will give his angel to take charge of him, and that they will bear him in their hands, lest he dash his foot against the stone." But in the process, Jesus Christ replied him and told him that it is written that you shall not tempt the Lord your God, and him alone you are going to serve. Satan did not leave Jesus Christ alone. He proceeded for the third temptation. He took Jesus Christ to a high mountain. He took him to a high mountain and showed him the kingdom of the world and their glory. And he told Jesus Christ, "If you will fall down and worship me, if you will fall down and worship me, I'm going to give you all the kingdom and their glory." But Jesus Christ replied and told him, "It is written, 'Be gone, Satan, for you shall worship the Lord your God, and only him shall you serve.'" That was when the devil left him, and the angels of the Lord came to minister to him. I am using the account of Matthew. The three synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, wrote on this temptation of Jesus Christ. I am using the one of Matthew because that one explains the temptation in detail. So that is the temptation of Jesus Christ. But in the first place, what is temptation? Temptation means to persuade someone to do something that is wrong or unwise, that is wrong or unwise. So that is not temptation. Temptation means to persuade someone to do something that is wrong or unwise. Temptation is not a sin, But it is when you yield to temptation that it becomes a sin. It becomes a sin. Jesus Christ was tempted, and he did not yield to the temptation. So the world we are living today, because of the economic, social, and political reasons, temptation can come. It can come from our parents. It can come from our fellow students. It can come from our colleagues. It can even come from our teachers. Temptation is normal when you don't fall into it. But when you fall into that temptation, that is where it becomes a sin. I pray that God will give us the grace not to fall into temptation in Jesus' name. Amen. That will take us to the explanation of the temptation of Jesus Christ. Like in the first temptation, Satan saw Jesus Christ as the economic Messiah. Saw him as economic Messiah. By placing the physical need over the spiritual need. What I'm asking in essence is that Satan saw Jesus Christ as an economic Messiah, that he should turn stone to bread. He placed the physical need over the spiritual world need, which was not supposed to be like that. And in the second temptation, Satan saw Jesus Christ as a walking wonder desire. He saw him as a walking wonder desire. What do I mean by that? By asking Jesus Christ to fall down from the pinnacle of the temple, that he will give his angel to take charge over him. That is to say, he expects Jesus Christ to perform miracles for more followers or more members to follow him. Then in the third temptation, he saw Jesus Christ as a political Messiah, who was to come to fight the enemies and to rule over them. But in all the temptation, Jesus Christ did not yield to it. Today, there are so many reasons why young people fall into temptation. There are so many reasons why people fall into temptation today, especially the young ones, our political leaders, in every sector. A lot of people fall into temptation. And what are the reasons? Temptation can come through the following way. Number one, especially in the world today, you see a lot of people, they steal and tell lies. Temptation in the world today. Temptation in the world today. A lot of people steal and tell lies. And apart from telling lies, a lot of people join secret cults. Number three, temptation can come through cheating during exams. That is examination malpractice during examination. So temptation in the world today, especially the younger ones, or on the other hand, it can be students. Temptation can come through stealing and telling lies. People join secret cult. It has been in the school system today, most of the secondary school, primary school. They join secret cult. A lot of people were tempted to join cult. Then cheating during exams. Temptation can also come. A lot of people become drug addicts. Some give or take bribes. take bribes in our offices, then
a lot of people involved in human trafficking.
Involving in human trafficking. Trafficking and drug abuse.
A lot of people involved in human trafficking and drug abuse. Child abuse. There is the practice of prostitution. A lot of people disobey law and order to be discerned.